Welcome back friends. Today we are going to solve lint coat problem 11-12 set mismatch. This problem was asked previously in Amazon, as you can see here. So let's go through the description quickly and we will see how we are going to solve this. The set S originally contains numbers from 1 to n, but unfortunately due to data error, one of the numbers in the set got duplicated to another number, which results in repetition of one number and loss of another number. Given array nums representing the data status of this set after the error, your task is to firstly find the number that occurs twice and then find the number that is missing. Return them in the form of array. So they have given us two examples. So let's take this example over here. So we have been given an input numbers array, this one. And we have been given so we have to find out a duplicate number, right? So duplicate, as you can see here, is 2, right? So this one we have to return as the first element in the output array, and the missing number you can see is the 3, right? Because 1, 2, 3, 4 is the 4 number sequence, but 3 got missed because it got duplicated with 2, so we have to return 3 here basically. So what we will do is we will just iterate through these numbers in a for loop from 1 to n, like from 0 to n minus 1, right? Because 0 based index, and we will keep adding them into a set, right? We will use a hash set in Java, so we will add them into our set. So let's go through this example. So we are at 1, we add 1 into set. We are at 2, we add 2 into this set. We will always check if set already contains that number, right, before we add it. Now again, when we are trying to add 2, then we will check first that if number already contains into the set, yes, then we will assign it, we will have a duplicate variable and we will just assign that value to our duplicate variable. So we got a duplicate number, and then for the next number we will just put it into set, right, 1 to 4. Now that is one loop we will do. Now we will do another loop in the for loop again for this array, and then what we will do in this set is we have to find out the missing number now, right? Missing number. So missing number is we will again iterate and we will check into the array every number. If it is from, basically what we will do is 0 to n minus 1, right? N minus 1. So we will actually, what we will do is when we are iterating in the next for loop, we will iterate from 0 to n basically, right? Means in this case, 1 to n, in this case 1 to 4, right? Because the numbers are from 1 to 4 in the array, as you can see here. So we will check 1 is there in the set, yes. Then we will check 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4 we have, because that is the sequence in the for loop, right? I. So 2 is in the set, yes. Then 3 we will check in the set, no, it's not in the set. So we will just call that as a missing number 3, and then we will just form an array and we will just return this as our answer, right? So that is the approach. The time complexity is order of n for this solution, as well as space complexity is also n, right? Because we are using a set to store n elements here, this set. So let's go quickly through the implementation. Is very straightforward. Array is there for 2, that this is we have to return as our answer, right? Then we defined a hash set here and we created two variables, duplicate and missing. Both are initialized at minus 1 in the beginning, right? Then we are iterating through 0 to the nums length, right? Like the whole array, basically this array, right? And if we are finding that number into the set, we will call it duplicate. Otherwise we will add the number into the set, right, as I explained in the here, right? And then again in the next for loop, now our next for loop is starting with 1, right? 1 to the it will be I equal to nums of length, right? I is less than equal to nums of length, which means 1 to 4 it will go, and it will check 1 to 4 numbers here. Whenever it does not find a number, we'll just call it as missing here, and we'll just form an array here and we'll just return the array. So again, these are two separate for loops. It is order of n and set is there, so it will occupy space order of n for space complexity. So let's run this solution with the given example. So it's passing, so we'll just submit this. So So our solution got accepted 92.8% better in the performance, which is pretty good. So this is the way you can solve set mismatch, one of the frequently asked Amazon questions. Make sure you can write the code and you can without any kind of editors, and make sure that it works, because we have to write the code in the coding exams without any editor, right? So you have to remember all the syntax and everything, so you will not find any help or anything. So make sure that you can write the code without editor, and check out my lead code playlist. It has over 80 solved problems that are explained with examples in detail Java code. So make sure you go through it, as well as go through my other playlist, which includes Java interview related playlist and different concepts like VFS, DFS, dynamic programming, and Java API data structures also I discussed, which include like java.util basically, which includes all collections, linked list, array list, hash map, hash set, tree map. Go through them. Make sure also you go through the tree map. It has also important methods, so make sure you go through all those stuff if you are preparing for coding interviews as well as for telephone interviews, right? If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. Your subscription will be really valuable, so the video can reach to more people like you who are preparing for interviews. So please subscribe to the channel, and thanks for watching the video.